commandments. Folks, the hope is that the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world. If you're struggling with a sin cycle, if you're struggling with generational baggage that maybe you can't control, maybe you really were handed, you were dealt this hand in life. I get it. Nobody's blaming you this morning. Again, this is a family atmosphere. Nobody's here to play the I gotcha card. Nobody's here to point a finger because we're all in the same boat. We're all sinners. But there is hope this morning because there is a Savior. There is hope this morning to break your generational sin cycle because God sent His Son to bear the curse of Adam on a tree, and He shed His blood to break every chain, to loose every shackle, to renew you, to redeem you. And David, the very man who saw his sin's consequences before his eyes, says, no, there is hope because there is a God who removes our sin. As far as the east is from the west, no, don't remember me by my sin, because God doesn't. He does not look down on me, David, as the adulterer who killed somebody, whose all his sons went astray. No, He looks down on me as from His steadfast love and His kindness and His graciousness and His compassion. He knows my frame. He knows that I'm just dust. You can partake in that generational blessing. You can have that righteousness as your own this morning. It's available to you as a free gift, in fact. Eternal life, a home in heaven. Just receive it. Just come to the cross. Just admit your sin cycle. Just admit it and let Him break it through His power, through the illumination of the Spirit, by the name of Almighty God.